everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Got a half-decent streak going on here. Cat, why do you choose to eat the cardboard? Of all the things we provide you, you rip off cardboard and eat it and swallow it? What is wrong with your brain? You not have, like, a cat switch in your evolutionary brain that's like, hey, there's food, don't eat cardboard. You're freaking me out, buddy. Alright, QC8JCVLC. I gotta be honest with you, this is a fantastic seed. Right from the get-go here, we have the cancer item, and it looks like decent damage, and red candle, and a lot of HP. I'll get my mouse pointer off the screen, my apologies for that. Rate of fire and or shot speed seem pretty garbo, but the big garbo is the fact that I just freaking said garbo, which I really, like, I'm not proud of myself for that one. Apart from that, we got a ton of tolerance on this run. Like, Red Candle is an item that can almost win you the game single-handedly. Some people might argue that I could get rid of that almost. Sure, yeah, and then on top of that, we'll take Rotten Baby and Whore of Babylon. Two of the better deal with the devil items in the game for sure. So all of a sudden, our damage-related problems are gone, and our run is pretty much won as long as I don't just completely squander it with shit damage. Like, really, this is... I'm not want to hesitate to say it, but it's one of the best Eden starts I've ever had. Really, in a way, I'm going to make this a complaint. Because it feels like the only way I can go here is down. You know, if I win, people are going to be like, oh, that's expected. Way to go, you won a run that was easy. But if I lose, well, that's where the interesting part comes in. But anyway, let's, instead of being complaining about it, why don't we just say, hey, thanks for the free items. Like, that would probably be... a little bit more of an awesome thing for us to do. We also just picked up two of diamonds, and there's a freaking item. It's not very good, you know, it's blood rites, but if we get Isaac's heart on our item room, we could maybe, I don't know, look for a flying card, because we're not going to get one on our deal with the devil, obviously, but maybe we'll fight Headless Horseman or something like that, and we'll be able to pick it up. Maybe we can make everybody's dreams come true all at once. Pinky Eye continues our good luck. That's a decent trinket. Probably I used to overrate it, but... now I consider it good enough, especially when you got nothing else taking its place. Not a flying enemy, but we will get our first level cube of meats. And honestly, that's pretty good. Nothing wrong with a spirit heart and a cube of meat on our first floor. Really puts us in a good position to be able to get a deal with the devil on the next floor. That's really where it's going to get into a tricky spot as far as HP goes, but hopefully we'll just get more HP on this floor and then we won't have to worry about it. Alright, we did sneak out a little bit of fire there. Unfortunately, the champion survived long enough to die in three hits after making it outside of the fire. Rosary Bead, I'm not interested in at all. Super Gluttony. If we get him killed, we saw this on one of the races with Mathis. If we got him killed near the corner, he can sometimes drop his item outside of the bounds of that, like, island that he's on. Which is actually incredible. I don't know if it's worth standing around for, you know... 10 minutes trying to get him to do it, but either way, I'm happy that we've learned something about that. PhD is our item. Pays out with a Tears upgrade right off the bat. You know, PhD is quietly, I hate using quietly as an adjective because it's so overused, but it is quietly one of the better item room items. You know, if we'd gotten just a Tears upgrade in there, we would have been like, sweet, a Tears upgrade. Well, we got a Tears upgrade plus HP, we couldn't see it because we're all on Spirit Hearts, but plus HP, plus all good pills for the rest of the game. So that it's really a huge upgrade. PhD is underrated, I think, because it just does what it does. Like, it's not flashy about it. But I really feel like... oh, and it's also variable. Like, to be fair, you can get PhD and then get, like, no pills after that. And that's a pretty shit draw. But if you do get pills after it, then it's well worth it. But it, I guess, you know, it's highly dependent on whatever your first pill is. If you get PhD, Tears up, HP up... you know, something like that, you're in a great place. If you get PhD Lemon Party, you're probably like, eh, it's just okay. Not that Lemon Party is bad. Holy shit. Holy Mantle is just chilling there. Really hoping for a flying item from our deal with the devil here. It's rare to see an item just kind of hanging out. It happens, but it doesn't happen all that often. To see two on consecutive floors is blowing my mind here. Well, unfortunately, it was just a tease. We're not going to be able to get it. Unless... and I will take a crack at this just because it's Holy Mantle, you know, it's a special item. I mean, I don't know if it's literally a special item, like it's in the special pool, but it might be. But the reason, or what I'm going to go for here is I'm going to try to find the Bible. It's no Bible. But we'll double this, take the Steam Sale, and then get the heck out of Dodge. Maybe I'll buy the key as well. Goodbye, Holy Mantle. I hardly knew ye. I wish that we had had an opportunity. Wait a minute. No, we would have gotten those pills if we'd been able to. Right? Right, brain? On the bright side, we do, despite not getting a, you know, proper deal with the devil there, we do have deal with the devil precedent thanks to our first floor, you know, the red chest that teleported us there. So we still will get deals with the devil instead of deals with the angel. Unfortunately, now we start paying the penalty after, you know, being lucky enough to not have to worry about it on the first floor. And you know what? Lump of coal's fine. If it gave us Krampus's head, I might have been a little salty about it. As salty as you can be on a run like this, but, yeah, with the Krampus's head, or sorry, with the lump of coal pickup, I'm pretty pleased about it. We picked up a good item. At least a decent item. Alright, we got I Can See Forever as our pill, another good one, and let's remember that this is all as a result of that PhD. Well, maybe, maybe not. Some of it is as a result of this PhD. I might not have taken the pill right away if I hadn't had PhD, but I might have. I don't know. I'm giving it more credit than it deserves. You know, PhD can survive on its own merits. It doesn't need me to fight its battles for it. This is great, though. I Can See Forever for next floor. Two health upgrades, which we should try to fill. Balls of Steel and Bombs Are Key. Bombs Are Key, not very interested in. And then Puberty, which we'll just take. Alrighty, Chubb. Chubb is already basically 50% dead, and that is, it's only going to get faster as I have less minions to deal with, and he's done. Deal with the devil? No deal with the devil, that's fine. Give us an extra floor to get our stuff together. Honestly, I know that this is a little bit lazy, but I'm going to leave. I've been racing with Mathis all day, so I'm in like a little bit of the speedrun mindset, but at the same time, I'm also like, why wouldn't I? You know, we already went to our item room, and we're not going to go to our shop. Probably. Maybe we could have if I hadn't left, but I'm not going to worry too much in a situation like this where we're already, like, so sorted. Like, not S-O-R-D-I-D. I'm not really much of a sorted guy, honestly. But we're sorted, which I'm not very organized, but I do like it when things are sorted. In more like an English sense, you know? Like, handled. Our shit is together, I guess is the way that I'm trying to describe. Okay, please stop jumping. Raid as I am about to fire my shit here. I don't know why I'm using such crass language. It is getting a little late at night. Maybe my brain is like, give me a break, give me a break. You've had your whole life to be a break. Or to be at break, I guess I should say. No secret room there, so let's check this out. You know what? I'd rather save my bomb. And we made a mistake there, but that's okay. Small price to pay. We did get to save our bomb, so if we only find, or if we find one tinted rock, and no bombs, we'll be able to take advantage of it. I don't honestly know what I'm looking for at this point. It feels like, it feels disingenuous to ask for anything. That was a very tight dodge there that got us through. Tight in the, you know, the physical sense, not in the tight sense, I don't know. Is that an old, is that outdated terminology? Yo, those kicks are tight, man. Yo, you got a Gen 2 iPad? That shit is tight. Does it have breakout on it? Oh, damn, son. That's tight. Only early 2000s kids will remember this. I'm not going to go down that road. I apologize. Okie dokie. That's pretty good. We might as well take our time to blow this up. Like, that's laziness that I cannot stand for. We haven't found any of our special rooms. We might as well get the consumables. It doesn't cost us anything to do so. I would like some more damage. I don't think that's wrong to ask for. We've had a Tears upgrade, and we've had Horror Babylon, admittedly, but apart from that, we haven't really upped our damage as much as we've improved other stuff on our run, so I would like the opportunity to improve some other stuff on our run. Mostly the, or improve our damage specifically. Less other stuff, nebulous other stuff that I'm not gonna worry about defining, because that forces me to actually have a point instead of just rambling incessantly, which is kind of, my thing. Okay, let's, get some orbital damage done here, if possible. Easy to land that one in there. And if we just stand here and then run away at the last possible second. It's just like social anxiety. Tell yourself what you're gonna do and then run away just before it almost comes to fruition. That's not a joke at the expense of those suffering from social anxiety. It's just a joke coming from somebody. At least mild form of social anxiety, but, you know, I understand. You know, agonizing over the choice you're gonna make at the deli counter because you don't want the butcher to judge you. Oh, look at this guy. He's getting the rosemary ham instead of the old-fashioned honey glazed. What an asshole. He doesn't understand. The old-fashioned honey glaze is my signature specialty that I've spent my whole life working on, and I'm not gonna tell him because I just expect him to know. Because that's how society functions inside of your brain. Anyway, let's move onwards from that. This is what I was looking for right here. Item room and shop. At this point, I'm hoping for mapping. We don't need much else. I mean, from the item room, I'd prefer some form of damage or a cool tier effect. But from the shop, I'd like mapping. And there you go. 2020 is pretty much exactly what I would have wanted from that item room. No mapping, we don't really need the battery, so as far as I'm concerned, we don't need anything. Maybe you buy that half-price pill, but I don't really care. That was my nickname in high school, half-price pill. No, I wasn't a drug addict, I just, I took a lot of medicine. Should've used a different voice for that, but that's okay. I know we're leaving 1 cent on the ground there. You'll forgive me, I hope. How's it going, Tomo? You just lounging? He's got his arms draped over the side of my desk like, yeah, man. I'm just chilling. This is my desk. It's not your desk, Tomo, but you probably have no concept of property ownership. I know cats are territorial, but, you know, pretty much in the possession is 9/10 of the law sort of way, right? Like, I can show you a receipt, but I doubt that you will be able to process that with your cat brain. He just moved. He's like, all right, asshole. You know, if you wanna get on this pedantic discussion, you know what? I'll just go sleep somewhere else. Tech point 5. Absolutely, completely okay. Converter? Blank card. I'm gonna use converter, like, almost all the way, like, that much. Just so we have more to work with on Deals with the Devil. Blank card? If we can get a card, sure, I'm into it. But, without getting a card, I don't really care. I didn't even really, like, the only reason I used converter is because we bought it accidentally, you know? Might as well get some use out of it. It's like if you win a juicer or something like that, you're like, I don't really want to make juice, but might as well use the juicer. We've got it. So we owe it to ourselves, I think, to crack open some of these. And now we got blank card jokers, so that's just, like, freaking dynamite right there. Might as well use blank card joker at all available opportunities because it's not like we're, That's convert. No, it's blank card. Okay. Because it's not like we are going to run out. We have like a limitless supply. Headless baby. Completely acceptable. Might as well buy another charge for it. I guess we can teleport out of a room if we find it along the way. But I'll still be hoping for some mapping at some point. That was actually a surprisingly good use of our money. We paid 7 cents for some pretty solid changes, I think. That was obviously terrible damage. But I'm going to save bombs and keys for now. I don't really want to use them to open golden chests. We're not broke on them, but we're not so flush with them that I want to just give them away. What I got you gotta give it to your teller. Oh, what I got you gotta give it to your pen as well. You thought I was talking about the bank, but actually I was talking about some famous skeptic magicians. That was just let me die. Blank card algas, fun, but not what we need. Blank card stars, won't you cars? Please tell me why won't you cars? It's over. So I should never record. It's past my bedtime. It's not, but it's past my working bedtime. Which is a phrase that I'd never thought of until today, but it sort of makes sense. If we wanted, you know, blank card stars is what we'd want to maybe get out of the boss rush room, but we already have a teleportation set up, so we don't need to worry about it. I'm still hoping for a little bit more damage, honestly. Like, we are obviously not going to get it here unless you consider a second orbital, like, or second level orbital, like, a big damage increase, which is foolhardy. But, you know why we're so low? Because I freaking had Moonstar, aka Whore of Babylon, and just squandered it with the converter. What the heck were you thinking there? I think I'm just going to head down to the next floor, because we've already gone to item room and shop. But, yeah, I was like, why is my damage so bad? Maybe because you're picking up all this HP, you dummy? Well, maybe we can get IV bag and get low, or I don't know. I'd rather just, I guess, teleport to the deal with the devil and trade our shit, but we'll use Guppy's Paw to do the anti-converter if we get lucky. Alright, well, that's obviously a lot of money. And we've picked up Whore of Babylon again. HP's not in a great place, but let's use our Joker. And we get Sister Maggie, which at this point we have to, well, we don't have to, but we might as well take, because there's no downside. And all of a sudden, our damage is not so bad. There you go, another health upgrade. Okay, I don't know if that's good or bad, but it is what it is. What's going on in this room? Nothing much. Okay. Well, it is the depths too, so we have, like, a little bit of time. We want to do boss rush and then teleport out, probably. This is a losable run because of my own idiocy. I traded all of our spirit hearts for red hearts and then traded all of our red hearts for money so I could get back into our health bereft state. This is what I was hoping for. A single black heart, pretty good deal, actually, because we need it. And I'd like to not get hit there. Speed upgrade, we're already very fast, but a little extra speed is fine. I'm not going to say that it never hurt anybody, because sometimes I have been hurt by excess speed. Not like the narcotic. Just the fact that I call it a narcotic should tell you that I have no idea what I'm talking about when it comes to illicit, you know, class 4, schedule 4 drugs. I was going to say amphetamines. I don't even know if speed is an amphetamine, but everything I know about drugs comes from Breaking Bad. And that one time that we did that anti-drug program in high school, and a police officer came to our school and told you that PCP made you superhuman, which was really a bad marketing technique if you're trying to be anti-PCP. The officer was seriously like, yeah, we got called to this, like, downtown apartment, and this guy was high on PCP, and we had to shoot him, like, 12 times to take him down. And then we're like, that's kind of awesome. Like, it's not, it's obviously there's great human cost to the war on drugs and yada yada. Okay, let's get that out of the way first. But also, that's amazing. Tell me more about how this illicit drug turns you into, like, the goddamn Man of Steel, basically. We're a bunch of, like, 11 to 12 year olds. And you're like, hey, PCP makes you immune to bullets. Never do it. And all right. That being said, I have never taken PCP. I don't know if it's, I might as well pick up HP now. Might as well. It might not be as a result of that. But it might be, I don't know. I don't know why it worked on me. I guess I just never really ran in circles where PCP was available. We have to take this. We might as well take that. And let's donate as much money as they'll let us, which is not very much. But there is an item room, and the item room contains Proptosis, which is lovely. This is one hell of a run. I squandered it a little bit, but I still am very, very pleased with the way it worked out, and we should not really be in much trouble. Face only a mother could love. This is what I imagined that the dude looked like when he was high on PCP. Let's get off this topic of conversation and head to our boss fight, where I assume that we will destroy Mom very quickly. Watch out. I wanted the hand to come out. I was trying to bait it out just a little bit. Just a little bit. Oh, that was terrible damage on my part. But we got the job done. I was going to say no deal with the devil. Then I was like, why do I care? Okay. Shit, man. I guess we'll take the passive. I love Blue Baby's only friend. It's just not great for us in our current situation. And we'll head down to the next floor. Really, like, I don't even... I would like to become Guppy, obviously. We have Hive Mind now, so becoming Guppy would be sweet. We do have Rotten Baby, so it's not like a total wash if we don't, but I would love to just get Guppy's paw so we can get in our Whore of Babylon state permanently. That's pretty much like the big draw for me. If we can't become Guppy, just give me Guppy's paw, man. Come on, living for the Guppy. If not, at least a taste of the Guppy's paw. That was, yes, you know, for those of you asking, that was Money Talk by AC/DC. This was the attempt, at least. Balls of Steel. Well, that'll pay for our little venture here. Ooh, interesting. Ooh, useless. But good to have, so it's not going to show up on the Deal with the Devil, I guess, where we will take absolutely everything and definitely not die. Gimpy's a big help, actually. I don't know what our luck stat is like, but I appreciate it. Traded one bomb for two bombs. Pretty excited about that little turn of events. Master negotiator here. Alrighty. Let us head downwards. In my experience, It might be anecdotal, but I feel like big room equals a greater chance for the boss room to be in that area. Keep in mind, we also have the cancer item. So we get hit more than once, we're not taking 2 times the damage. We're taking 1.5 times the damage, which is pretty exciting, if you ask me. Might want to pick up these red hearts. I mean, we're not going to get in the Horde of Babylon state anyway, so we might as well just take red hearts so that if we give away too much HP, we don't die in the process. I wonder if Blue Baby's only friend actually does more damage than our tears right now. I know we have Proptosis. I know we got all that good stuff, but I can't shake the feeling that maybe it would. But there's third level of Meat Boy. I didn't even think of that. We don't have BFF, unfortunately, but that's still a really nice pickup for us. We're not really going to use our orbitals that much at this point, so to be able to have a Meat Boy is pretty nice. Hopefully this is the right way. The second secret room is over here. That's really, it's not a foolproof means of figuring out where the heck the boss room is, but it's better than nothing. I should be dead. You know, just, yeah, thank you. Much appreciated. You're too good to me. Couldn't have done that myself, thank you. Ooh, this could be good though. Puberty, health up. Why not, right? Like, maybe if I didn't take all these health upgrades, it would be easier for us to get into the Horde of Babylon state, but I don't know, we're kind of riding the line between needing HP and needing damage, so I'm happy with our current situation, so I'm just gonna stick with the equilibrium, basically. Thank you. Okay, don't need the money. We'll come this way. I had a feeling that would be a dead end. Oh, Lord, what is this room? This is all of my nightmares stacked up on top of one another in one kind of nightmare stack of pancakes. This is like 20 different obstacles I hate rolled into one. We did do it, though. Only to follow it up with another room that is also, like, pretty annoying. But at least this one gives us a pretty good chance of getting a tinted rock. I do not see one, though. Alright, that's fine. We're only one room away from being able to get another deal with the devil anyway. And if it's Guppy's Paw, man, we're at full HP. Combined with the extra damage bonus, combined with the invincibility. This is good stuff. Stay close. Stay close and stay limber. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. And don't forget to parody ACDC. Okay, 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 okay. Keep our momentum high here. This is a very fast run. I mean, I skipped a lot of rooms, but it's also just a very fast run due to our damage, I guess. I tried to pick it up. You saw me try to pick it up. And, you know, that's my own failure in terms of due diligence, but we'll just teleport back anyway. A little disappointed, though. Like, what the heck was going on with that? Tinted rocks? I don't see any. It's very unfortunate, because I consider those pretty integral to our chances for success here. Lots of HP, though. We can, you know, use that for the future. And we found 2 dead ends, so we know it's not straight up or straight down, which makes a ton of sense, actually, now that I think about how most floors are laid out. But, gotta try anyway. And we'll go back and get Sacrificial Dagger, which I think is going to be probably largely useless unless we find a way to get permanent Polaroid invincibility. But we're, like, on this run, we are fine. I don't want to make it seem like we're in a dangerous spot. We're actually in an amazing spot. And I'm not too worried about this run defensively, even though it might look like I should be. 3 HP on the Cathedral is a position I'm very comfortable with. We might as well go back for that when we can. Oh, I forgot about this room. Am I on? No, I'm on hard mode. I was like, these room layouts. Whenever I see new room layouts, now I get very suspicious. I'm like, oh shit, am I on normal mode by accident? But no, that's not the case here. Just variance, I suppose. I appreciate the keys. We don't have Guppy's Tail to the best of my memory, but it's okay. Oh, this is where we started. Okay, so we looped around that way, maybe down here. It's tempting to play that judgment. Why would I not? I think we really should. There's enough HP if we walk on the spikes. There's not really a valid excuse that I can come up with, which is a good way of conceptualizing that it's probably the right decision to make. Come on, red chests, red chests, red chests. Not red chest, but we could teleport out. Oh, yeah, okay, I'll just... Don't hit me with a bomb. I'll be real mad. I'll be salty as heck. Mapping, though. Okay, that could be good. Got something at all for me here? Okay, that's great. Paid for itself already. Now's where you pay out with the mapping. No! I saved your life. You owe me HP or mapping. That's also, like, not good enough. I'm sorry. I wish it was. That's, like, decent, but coming to the point where I've given you, like, 28 cents, you need to pay out something a little brighter than this, man. Blankheart Emperor. I don't know, okay? Here's what I'm thinking. Pop that open. Joker card out. Leave again. I knew that guy was going to drop a spirit heart, so... I didn't know it, but I know it now. I mean, Emperor wins us the game. But where's the fun in that? The fun is in having an extra Joker, I think. Or one extra deal with the devil, I should say. So prove me right, Judgment. Prove me right. Give me a good item. Is this the rare Judgment that actually takes like 80 cents and never pays out with anything? Because that's pretty messed up. Alright, well, you're making me want to take the Emperor card, just so you know. You're being kind of a dick about the whole thing, but I'm not going to be too mad about it, okay. Admittedly, we could use the, we could use a bomb, access that chest. This is where Sacrificial Dagger's not going to be too bad. And then give some of that money to Judgment, assuming it paid out with money. But that's like, you know, yeah, I suppose we could empty out our retirement funds to pay this Nigerian prince that just emailed us, but is that really a good idea? No, it's not, in case you have to ask. That's a terrible investment. You're gonna lose your money, and people are gonna laugh at you, and you're gonna go through a very difficult time in your life. I'm not speaking from experience, I'm just saying I imagine that's probably how it goes. Now, I'd like you to drop some HP so I don't have to backtrack in order to go into that curse room and feel like good about it. He didn't. And that's on you, okay? I can go to sleep at night knowing I put in an honest effort here. Can you say the same? There is a half heart there now, so I'm kind of tempted. Yeah, you got the right idea, Meat Boy. Just keep it up. Key a half red heart. This is our boss area. Just drop like another red heart. That's all I ask. It's not that much of a... Not that much of a favor, honestly. Eternal Heart is better. You actually gave me more than I wanted, and I'm mad about it. I wish you had not done that. I can't believe you've done this. Okay, he's dead already. He just doesn't know it yet. There we go. A full red heart now, between the two rooms. If you could just maybe hook me up with one more here. I just don't want to... Oh, we freaking got it. Okay, I can stop being a little baby about it now. Go into our curse room. It was a spirit heart, unfortunately. I say unfortunately because two spirit hearts would at least... Oh, never mind. We are good. Gimpy paid out. And actually, we can just take the half heart now. And that will allow us to get some invincibility. It's a good situation. I don't know. How's this looking? It's not as much damage as we're doing. Oh, God. Don't lose the HP. You just got it. You just got it. He didn't summon any angels. Wow, he summoned two angels right at the end. Okay, we got them. We got them. We got them before they get attacked. That's good. Not really hitting too much there, but that was the best we could do in that situation because he was firing the shots directly at us. Okay, that was better. This is good. This one could do it if we get a little luckier. Maybe one more fly there could have sunk him. But instead, his battleship travels onwards. Now, this is where we find out if I made the smart decision or the dumb decision. Emperor card was left behind in favor of the Joker card. In favor of one extra deal with the devil because I am a freaking believer, okay? Now, I'm not happy about Robo Baby. I'm pretty stoked about Skinny Odd Mushroom, admittedly. I do like that item. We got Missing Page, too. And then I saw her face. And I'm a believer. Not a trace. A doubt in my mind. I've been fucked. I used to be a believer. If I doogity 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 doogity. Shrek. Okay. I don't know why. I want to make a Kendrick Lamar Shrek joke. It's like, if these walls could talk, Shrek. Okay, can I just do, we'll leave that one up there for, Mouth Sounds 3.0 or something. It'll work. All right, I'm not part of the Shrek core movement. I came up with an idea, and I think it's better to give it to the world than hold it inside. She just wants to close her eyes and Shrek it. With you, with you, with you. All right. Please. This is not the right direction. We're still gonna win, like it's the world's easiest run. But I squandered about 40 opportunities here to do a little bit better. And, I'm slightly salty regarding that situation. But also, I gotta admit, our blank card joker let me the heck down here. Nothing too special came about as a result of it. But the real misplay, and it's a surprising one considering I almost never use this item, but the real misplay was definitely Converter. I don't know what possessed me to use Converter. But what's done is done. And this run is done. We're going to win. Unless there's a terrible accident. That was not the enemy I wanted to kill last. Thank you very much, but I guess if you're going to force my hand, that's okay. We do have both of the items that, we have both of the familiars that we can direct in order to do damage, but it's not that good. This would have been an amazing run for BFF. Hive Mind is great. I appreciated showing up, but if BFF had showed up, we've got, 12 familiars here, including third level Meat Boy and Sacrificial Dagger, Blue Baby's Only Friend, combined with Robo Baby 2.0. We could have really made some impressive stuff happen there. Libra? I mean, I don't even know. Let's take it. It could be weird. Rate of Fire seems to have gone way up. Speed is lower, which to me means probably damage has gone up, because our damage stat was not particularly strong before. So I'm pretty impressed with this Libra pickup, I guess. That was not smart, but I was like, I'll play chicken, and that'll really give us an indication of how strong we are. And it did, and I was not happy with the result, but that's okay. Range up, that's all stats up now. Huge play, not really. But decent play, really. Bad damage and no gimpy pay out there. Suboptimal. More bombs. Oh, that's a second secret room. Okay, just don't get killed on the way out here. If that was Guppy's paw, I would have flipped. I would have flipped my lid. Whatever that means. All right, that gives us a period of invincibility. I have a feeling we're on the right track here. Hard to say. Oh my god, he almost got me there. And I have picked up full HP, so now we do not have full invincibility, or a period of invincibility anymore. And I'm just eager for this run to be over so I can run away from my mistakes. Okay, fantastic. Thank you, Gimpy. And we're at, yes, we now have a period of invincibility. Through complete accident, I have made a smart play. But that's alright. Like I said, this run was almost preordained to win based on the way that first floor turned out. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. Helped out a great deal. Helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.